Girl Scout cookies are a pastime in the United States, and I have probably had over 100 boxes in my lifetime. But one held my heart. The Thin Mint. So today, in the anabolic laboratory, we will be making a Thin Mint Blizzard that is double the size, half the calories, and stuffed with protein when in comparison with the large Blizzard offered at DQ, which is one of their many summer blizzards. I already got you on the animal cookie. My name is Nick. I have my master's in exercise physiology, and I make anabolic recipes and also review anything to do in the fitness industry. So if you're into that kind of thing, like this video and subscribe to the channel. If you are ready to take this blizzard from a limited edition to all you can cream, then let's get into it. I always like to get the mix-ins ready first so we don't have to worry about it when we're trying to put stuff away, mix everything, make sure that everything is ready to go. So I'm gonna start with our grasshoppers. Nick, what? Grasshoppers? Yes, they literally taste the exact same as Thin Mints, but you can get them all year long. So these are the Keebler grasshoppers, and they have off-brand ones as well. You'll get them in the same section. And we're gonna use four of these. Now, shout out to Ashley Evelyn. She actually made a anabolic Thin Mint, but for ease of use and for ease of the actual instructions and quickness to make the shake, I'm going to use these. But if you do want more mix-ins slash less calories, you can make her Thin Mints and put them into your milkshake. Up to you. Now, per usual, I'm just gonna knife these down. I like to make a lot of smaller chunks for this one, really dust things, because you get it in every single bite. It's absolutely incredible. But you also want a couple big pieces throughout as well, where you're like, whoa, that was nice. But you know, do the pieces as you please. Mixin's ready to go. Now we get our scale, paper plate, and our ninja, and we weigh out our wet ingredients. We will start with milk, whatever milk you want, 65 grams. Then our Greek yogurt, which we will do 80 grams. 1 teaspoon of vanilla, or 4.2 grams. Now, this is crucial. This is something that you will have to order online. Some Meijers do have creme de menthe syrup, but most places only have an alcohol. And I went and bought the alcohol. I tried the alcohol. Didn't work, adds way too many calories. I have a lot of viewers that are under the age of 21, and it doesn't even add that same mint flavor. Now, I did it with peppermint, and you get about 70% of the taste, but you can't just sub out this for this. You will have to watch my animal cookie blizzard recipe to add this, because if you're not adding 14 grams of a wet liquid, it's completely going to mess up the consistency of this. Trust me, I tried it. And I also tried the peppermint, which it is very good flavor-wise, but literally with this, I could stand my Blizzard side by side Dairy Queens and it tastes the exact same. And yes, I did multiple side by side comparisons. Now we're gonna go with 14 grams of the syrup. By the way, this is $12 shipped to your door, and that gives you over 50 Blizzards to make, or it's like 24 cents every Blizzard to be able to use the same thing that they are using and to make it taste exactly the same. And then 2 grams of salt. Now, I am sorry for most of you guys that are outside of the country besides Canada and can't get Cool Whip, but I do not have a replacement for the Cool Whip. Like, I know some people were saying that they were making a homemade Cool Whip that they found on YouTube as well, but I don't have a replacement for you. Will I eventually have one? I might, but right now, this is just so readily available that I haven't looked into making my own or what other substitute that you can really use, especially for only 40 calories. Now we're going with 18 grams. You can use the fat-free or the light. Both work fine and both have the same amount of calories. Now 460 grams of ice. level the playing field. And we are going to blend for 1 minute, no more, no less. Make sure you're timing it out and I will see you back then. Okay, bye. Now you will already notice that this isn't the exact same consistency as the Animal Cookie Blizzard, but the syrup gives it a different consistency. Even in the real Dairy Queen Blizzard, can I still hold it over my head? Yes, but at the same time when I'm actually eating it, there is a little bit different of a consistency because of the syrup itself. Now we're gonna give this a good mix, bring everything from the top to the bottom and from the bottom to the top. We are going to use this exact order of ingredients to place on top of the ice cream all the way up. And we will start with our vanilla pudding mix, 7 grams. Guar gum and xanthan gum combined give you the best creaminess. If you don't have it, use 3 grams of one. But if you have both, which I highly suggest because they're only about $10 a piece and you will have them for like a year, 1.5 grams of xanthan and 1.5 grams of guar. Next, we have 1.25 scoops of your protein. I use whey. If you use a whey casein, it's gonna give it a different consistency. However, 1.25 scoops for me is about 41 grams. So whatever your 1.25 scoops is, use that and adjust accordingly the next time if it was too thin or too thick for your liking. I just worked out, so I need to add my creatine to here. I always get my creatine with my protein ice creams every day. But this is just optional. You don't absolutely need this by any means. I like to give this a good leveling again. And we will add our erythritol. This is about 15 grams that I like to add. This is all depending on the sweetness that you like though. Level it out one more time and we are going for another minute and we are almost to thin mint heaven. Now we gotta make sure we get everything off the walls and again, try to bring everything from the top to the bottom. What I like to do is like the windshield wiper effect. I like to bring cream up or else that protein really sticks. So we bring the cream up and we're gonna wipe it off with the spatula, like so. We're all mixed and ready to go. One more minute and it's time to eat. Look at this, nice and thick. Now what I like to do is add about 2/3, maybe 3/4 of the thin mints and we mix them in. And now see, hang it over, nothing. Now if you hang it for long enough, it's gonna come out. But like I said, this is the exact same consistency as at Dairy Queen. And watch. Literal heaven in a pitcher. Holy Christ. Oh my God. Oh, you're gonna love this. Let's go. Same story, different cream. We're getting upwards of 3/4 to 1/4 pitcher of ice cream for 500 calories. And let's top so we get to have extra thin mints in every single bite. Literally, as you could see, thin mints completely throughout, a nice chunk at the top, whether you want to take big fat wads of thin mints to the dome or you want to take it little by little along with the thin mints that are already dispersed throughout. It's your choice, but you are going to absolutely love it. It's hard to describe that syrup flavor. It like gives it a thickness, but a different type of thickness than like soft serve. I don't know how to describe it. You just gotta try it. At first, I was wary about buying that syrup. I was like, man, will it really make a difference? And I swear to you, night and day difference. That's why I say it's about 70% of what it could be if you use only peppermint extract. If you like my mint Oreo protein ice cream, you will absolutely love this. It's 2 different consistencies. It is 2 different flavors, regardless of the thin mints or not. The syrup gives it a completely different flavor than the peppermint, and it is just so damn good that you could just add this to your arsenal of anabolic creams that keep you satisfied, that keep you on your diet and getting towards your goals. Let's go over the macros so I can eat the rest of this. For the entire thing, we have 500 calories on the dot, 43 protein, 69 carb, and 11 fat, or actually, let me say 12 fat. I always round up. 500 calories, almost an entire damn pitcher. Thin mint ice cream that you can have year round, not just summertime, Dairy Queen. If peanut butter is more your taste, you should check out the Power 13 cookbook that I'm featured in that has a white chocolate peanut butter protein ice cream that is absolutely delectable as well. It is officially cream season. It is 80 degrees out and the creams are not going to stop for the rest of the summer. I promise you that. But until next time, I will see you in that next one. Deuces.